Here we go. It's my penultimate league match. Pin against NA Smith 99. I think it's the first time I play him in, well, some kind of tournament or league or something. What's going on here? So, Tomb is here. There's no plus. That's maybe not true. There's Animal Fair, but that's probably not going to be plus by. So, trash that. What do we do here? Pageant Mask, maybe. Trash a bit and then. Seems fine. Play with some bazaars and a wayfarer, something like that. Gain the silvers. Mean, I'm basically demoting no matter what, so I can just play for fun here. Doesn't really matter, but I will still try to play well, of course. Okay, there's tomb rats, but surprised. It's super nice to see the mask here immediately. He skips the mask. He wants to trash with threats. So, yeah, maybe the board isn't. Maybe it's a misread on my part. I mean, you can play with lots of threats and then keep on trashing them with raise and just score off tomb. It's a possibility. He doesn't have a mask, so I can also just trash this. I mean, I can still do that. However. How fast is that? Could get a pixie here. Could get a bazaar. I don't know. Let's get a pixie maybe. Here I take a bazaar. So, well, if the rats pile, then Animal Fair is gonna be plus by, but that takes a lot of effort. Yeah, maybe rats are good here, I don't know. It's extra gains at least, and you can do that, but I'm not that excited for a Animal Fair yet. Honestly, so let's pass this. What was the C? All right. I mean, I could buy a rats here, so that I can really buy some animal fares. I'm undecided here, as you might tell. I kind of wanted to take a wayfarer and then gain silvers with it. Okay, let's actually take a rats here. Whatever. We're here to have fun, right? Maybe I shouldn't have trashed that copper with the mask. Here I will take a rats if I draw it, which should happen, hopefully. Well, it's guaranteed. Then I can either take an animal fair or a wayfarer. Probably wayfarer is way better. So I can actually gain the silvers and retrash them. Okay, so let's play the pixie first. Two silvers, huh? So if I, not sure if I should take it. It's a bit sad to lose the pixie. It might give me the plus buy eventually. But silvers are decent. Let's keep it though. Not sure that I should trash here. Let's go with no. Trash a copper and buy a wayfarer. So, still having three coppers here. Maybe I should have trashed a bit more. Bit I'm a bit scared by the mask, but with a deck consisting of only nine cards, I mean, I think it's fine to have only two coppers, but and also passing gold is not a big deal. I guess I should have trashed one more copper. But either way is fine, I think. Am I missing some? Some patience here. I think I do. Oops. That's bad. I hope it was the first one. Maybe it wasn't. Oh well. So he has like five. No, he only has three. Three rats. Okay. Yeah, that's a fine number. But you can't like take all of the rats. You need more masks or raises if you want to have that many rats. And also you run out of food for the rats. So I don't know where this is gonna take him. He needs a Bayfair air so he can take silvers. This I keep. Okay, silver. So Bazaar here or a Wayfarer. Let's take a Bazaar. Some point I might pass the rats, but not yet. Of course. Yeah, I wonder what now. Should I just screen? Well, probably a second Wayfarer, but I mean, it looks like rats might run, so we could build a bit bigger with Animal Fare potentially. But it's still gonna take a while. Okay, let's hope I see a Bazaar here, and I don't. Take more silvers. Probably just a pixie here or a race. I mean, I just play two rats, so I have four now. Maybe I should take another race. But then again, I won't be able to play many. Well, with more wayfarers, I might be able to play more rats. So is it a wayfarer or is it a race? Maybe Wayfarer is better. Ideally, Wayfarer gains me a silver each turn. Ideally, Race trashes a rat each turn. So that's kind of the thing. Think I take a Wayfarer. It was a bit of a sad turn, but still fine. Yeah, pass the goat. Well, goat can also trash a rat, so maybe I shouldn't pass a goat. I should pass a silver instead. I think that's better. Yeah, so let's see what he does. Does he have something clever in mind with building pretty big here, or? Well, he can't really promise. I think he should maybe take another Bazaar or Wayfarer first. So what's the rats count? I think we both have. No, I have four and he has three, I think. So he has one card in hand, and that's. No, what am I? Yeah, he has. I mean, one other card than Rats. And what is that? He doesn't have a race, which is kind of cool. No, wait, I don't have a race. Nobody has a race. Yeah, so the deck with lots of Wayfarers and lots of Bazaars and lots of Rats is probably good here, I think. I made up my mind. Okay, so let's play these. Gain a silver. Play a mask so that I can pass copper first, I guess. Should I trash rats? I have five right now. Kind of nice to have some rats, but I think I can trash one. So I have four. Should I take like a gold? Gold doesn't really do much. So no, I want to take the buy at some point if I can get it. So I think I have five rats. I think I play that rats. I have six. Do I play more or do I just play the Wayfarer now? I think I play the Wayfarer. Gain silver. So it looks like I only have five rats, but that's fine. Five rats. Do I treasure rats? With how many rats do I want to play? I only have two Wayfarers, so five rats looks a bit much, and also I will regain some. I think I trash one rats and buy a Wayfarer. So four rats right now and three silvers. What do I pass here? Rats or mask? It's gotta be rats, so let's do that. Three rats in my deck. Yeah, so rats is obviously good here, but it's kind of good that I still came to that conclusion. So if I have three rats, then he has two. But he's out of food. He only has. Well, he does have Wayfarers. Like one or what? So I need another Bazaar probably next turn. And he needs another Wayfarer for sure. Animal Fare is kind of nice for him. So he doesn't hesitate trashing the rats. So he has. I mean, it's not that important. I think he has two. No, yeah, one in hand and one in play. Think he should buy Wayfarer. And I should probably buy a bazaar. I mean, basically, the ideal deck does have as many rats as it has Wayfarers and bazaars, basically. At some point, the silvers are gonna run out, though. Well, and the rats are gonna run out, and then it's probably shifting towards some thing with Animal Fare. He already has one, which is good for him. Yeah, he does buy a Wayfarer, so let's play Bazaar and the Wayfarer. Okay, a silver. Doesn't hurt to play the Pixie now. And the Pixie could come in really handy at some point, like three buys, and then I can maybe buy like some animal fairs and so on. Okay, let's play the Wayfarer. Okay, a silver. So three reds for me, that's gonna be four. Five. How many do I want? Oh, I shouldn't have trashed that copper. That was dumb. I mean, silver and copper, what's the difference, right? So five reds right now. Well, I'm not gonna play that mask anyway, so it doesn't really matter. Let's take more reds, so six. Discard doesn't look that great, but I need to play that Wayfarer, right? Should I stop here, maybe? I mean, the goat will also draw a card. There's like two silvers and three reds in there. Whatever. So seven. Okay, no, I drew all the reds. What am I talking about? So gain a silver. So six reds right now. What do I buy here? Bazaar, probably a bazaar. Animal fair could be decent. I kind of need another bazaar though. So I have six reds, three silvers, three bazaars. Let's see how many reds are left after his turn. Maybe none. Well, then I need to spend a turn buying animal fare. Would be time to get the plus buy boon now. I should be a bit ahead here, I think. I have one more Wayfarer and one more Bazaar. And my headset's complaining that the battery is low. I better plug it in. I hope that doesn't mess up my sound. I had some headset issues recently. I hope the sound is fine. Somehow it doesn't connect via the cable. I have to use the Bluetooth function for some reason. I think the sound quality is a bit worse with the Bluetooth function. Anyway, I have six reds, right? So he has five. Doesn't play more reds. So I could empty reds here and buy an animal fair. He's probably gonna buy an animal fair. Well, maybe he doesn't. The thing is, terminal space. Buys another bazaar. Okay, so bazaar, Wayfarer, gain silver. Seven rats. I think I play another rats. Eight rats, and now, yeah, I didn't draw another bazaar. Well, now I can play rats, right? Doesn't gain me more rats, so I have eight rats. Okay, nice. Gain a silver. Play a pixie. Here. Keep. Gain a silver. And now I just buy an animal fare. Last card is something, probably a silver. So can play the mask if I want to. I think I will play it now. Probably just passing reds around, right? Pass. Oh, wow. That's amazing. That's really amazing. Really, do you have to pass Wayfarer? Shocking. Okay, so now I have. I need the animal fare now. The question is if I treasure rats or not. Because now I have four Wayfarers. I'm over terminal next turn, but I think that's fine. Let's treasure rats. So right now I have six rats. Should I trash more rats? I mean, I have some options. I can trash one, two, or none here. I don't know. Trash like one, then I have five remaining. I can trash five cards each turn in theory. I think I will keep six for the moment. I might readjust at some point, but don't think there's a point to do so now. So I have six rats, and I will just buy an animal fare. Okay, nice starting hand. Not full of rats or something. So let's see how did it end up. He has five rats remaining. Okay. I'm really surprised he passed me a Wayfarer there, but I guess he had to. Not gonna pass him a rat. So he's gonna pass me a rat, okay. So seven four. And he even treasures rats, so 7-3. Interesting. Well, he doesn't have the Wayfarers now anymore. This game is still gonna take a while, so I like having the rats. Yeah, what am I buying if I draw? Bazaar and maybe another born Bazaar animal fare, I don't know. So is he going into provinces now, or is he just building more with bazaars? I mean, he only has three rats left, right? So long term should be good for me. So his hand is like what? Three rats, an animal fare, and four silvers. Is that it? Maybe. Well, now if we keep on trashing silvers, our payload is not. Trash is a gold. Expecting nothing. Okay, Wayfarer, animal fare, by trashing. So he only has two rats remaining. So what's the plan here for him? I don't really know. Okay, let's gain a silver. Well, this sort of had to happen. I wonder if I play rats. I think I do. What do I trash? Well, a silver, I suppose. Trashing the mask is fine, I think. Okay, nice. I did draw the bazaar. Gain a silver. Something like Earth Gift would be sad now, but I still play the pixie now. Wisp. It's two gains, but no thanks. I need the wisp. I need the pixie is what I mean. I mean, I could rebuy it, but it's nice to have it outright. So let's keep. I have to keep playing the rats, I think. Nice. Play a wayfarer. Get a silver. So what do I do now? Do I play another rats? I think I play another rats. And then maybe I shouldn't have. Do I play another rats? Kind of think I play another rats. Same amount of money for this turn might be a bit lower for next turn. So what am I buying? Two bazaars, maybe. Or bazaar. I kind of need one more bazaar to be thermally balanced. So I guess two more bazaars make some sense. The question is how many rats to play? How many rats to trash? Well, none, I suppose, if I'm buying two bazaars. Well, I can. I don't know. I think I'll leave it as it is. For the time being. Yeah, that means I can play more rats some other turn, maybe. And maybe I also want to have the silver, so. So he bought a second animal fair, which I think is also all right. Do I want that? The thing is, let's say I buy two bazaars and he buys like two bazaars. He does have three buys even. Is he then in a good position because he has more buys? I'm not so sure. It's not all about the buys. Ah, this is kind of close between Animal Fair and Bazaar for me. I could also buy Animal Fair Trashing or Rats, hoping to top deck a Bazaar. What happened with the other mask? He still has the mask. Let's say he buys two Bazaars. He can like Bazaar. Then he has like five buys. That's quite a number of buys. Yeah, I think I buy Animal Fair and even trashing the rats here. So I have five rats remaining. Guess I have to pass one as well. Which would bring it back to 4-4. But I still have more wayfarers, so I'm not sure how much use you can make of the extra rats. Still waiting for that. What's it even called? I'm so bad with the names. Forest. Forest gift. I'm not sure he can play rats anymore, really. Well, the problem is kind of that I trashed my mask. But I think it was right at the time trying to find my bazaar. I mean, the worst that can happen is that I have to pass a rat, right? Basically. Well, he's for some reason had to pass me a wayfarer, which I'm still surprised about that that happened. What was the hand like? Can't even imagine like three bazaars, a mask, and a wayfarer or something. Maybe an animal fair in there as well. Well, this is kind of strange. At some point, we could also just stop playing the rats and trying to go for gardens. I mean, that deck will fall apart pretty quickly, but I already have 20 cards in my deck. He only has 13. Yeah, I think buying Animal Fair last turn was actually the right choice. Having three buys is pretty good. You can buy more stuff and also more animal fares potentially by trashing rats. Ah, okay, he can't play the mask, right? He wants to play those. That's nice. Okay, those buys make sense. Okay, so still 20 silvers left. Okay, he thinks those buys don't make sense. Buys animal fare, trashing rats, and a bazaar, and a province. Okay, so bazaar, wayfarer, gain a silver. Well, I have to do this. Nice, okay. As I said, now I can trash more silvers if I have to. This, however, is a bit of a problem. Guess I just have to stop here. I have to stop here, I think. I have five reds, so down here are like lots of good cards, so at least I have them next turn. Okay. I could province. I could province. Kind of don't want to province. He has three animal fairs though, so he has four buys. So my gut says bazaar, wayfarer, animal fair, or bazaar, double animal fair. I have more rats, so I can make up points. what did I buy last turn again? Right now I'm over terminals by one. I'm not sure if that matters, but I kind of need another bazaar. Do I really want to lower that much? Bazaar, wayfarer, animal fare. It feels kind of good. Say he empties the bazaars. He has three buys. He can't empty something mid-turn. No, wait, he has four buys. So if I take Bazaar, Wayfarer, Animal Fair, then he potentially has a pile out. So I guess I shouldn't do that. Let's go Bazaar Province Animal Fair instead. Yeah, I think that looks good. It's kind of sad to not take another Wayfarer, but question is, do I trash the rats? Oh, I have to. That was dumb. All right. don't want to spend seven for an animal fare when I have $0 left. Yeah, this is a bit sad that I didn't draw any of these last turn. Yeah, I have to pass the rats. My last card is Pixie. Earth Gift could be really good. Gaining gardens. Okay, four buys, that's quite nice. He did get to all of his spies. Probably just double province Wayfarer or something like that. Yeah, not considering province last turn would have been, I mean, not taking province would have been a big mistake. I mean, it is about the provinces now. It's not like I can keep pretending I score with playing three reds a turn. So Earth and Forest are still in there, and some other useless ones, I think. Let's actually. I think River is still in there. Field is still in there, so it's Field, Earth. I mean, it doesn't really matter. I have the only Wisp, I'll just play it and see what happens. Just missing one. What's the last one? I think it's River, Field, Earth, Forest. Don't know what the last one is. Anyway, what is he gonna buy here? Like double province and the gardens? No, probably taking another Wayfarer. Could be double province, maybe double province Wayfarer, Animal Fair. Oh, two pixies. I think that's pretty clever. Dang it. Okay, bizarre. Where's my pixie? I thought the last card is my pixie. Did I play the pixie? I kind of missed that I played the pixie if I played it. Okay, whatever. Let's play this. Gain silver. Gain silver. Can score quite a bit here, but can I quad or something? I mean, Earth's still in here. I think I play the Wayfarer first. Do I take more silvers? I have four Wayfarers, so don't know. I also don't. Yeah, I'm not sure if I should play that last Wayfarer. Maybe I shouldn't even have played that one. I kind of need to play Animal Fairs. Let's gain a silver. Let's play rats. So I should actually check if I have. I can never quad, right? Let's say I play those four rats, drawing four silvers. Four silvers is eight. I have 8 plus 5, 13. Well, I also have to trash some things. No, I don't think so. Yeah, now I'm gonna get Earth and I can't use it. That's a problem. Field would also be amazing here, actually. Well, okay, there is the forest, actually. Cool. Cool. Does it help me? I have four actions. I can actually play everything here. Three silvers in the discard, so I can play like a Wayfarer now. No, I can't really count as the thing. I can't play that Wayfarer. So let's play a Bazaar. And then two rats, I think. So if I trash Wayfarer and Province here, I draw another silver. I have three silvers. 6 plus 8, it's 14 plus 12. That's some number, which is not 32, but 26. So let's just trash this silver. And a silver. Should I trash and let a silver? No. Well, it scores a point. But I think no. How did I arrive at 26? Well, if I trashed, not two silvers, right? Okay. What do I do here? Can he triple? He may be able to triple. I can't really take that last bazaar. Don't want to give him double plus buy on the thing. How many cards do I have? 2, 4, 6, 7, 8, 9, 14, 15, 16. Only 19 cards in my deck. If he can triple, I'm probably lost. Even though that's not completely clear, I mean, there are gardens and stuff. I don't have many uniques either. Like, feels like three uniques. So, what's the play here? Pixies look good, yeah, I have to say. He has three animal fairs, so four buys. Potentially more somehow with some trickery. Probably not, though. I wonder if I should play around him. Tripling. I could also like double province, duchy, double animal fair. It's also some points, but it easily loses to double with something with it. Have no clue here. I think he kind of outplayed me here a bit with the greening timing. I can't really take two provinces. I guess I have to take one and hope he can't triple. I think that's the play. And then what else? Bunch of pixies. Province costs 8. 13 left. Animal fair and some pixies, maybe. Do we even need the animal fair? Maybe not. But I don't want to lower too low. So only three pixies. Three pixies a province. That's 14. Okay, I think I have it now. Should I take the race? Whatever, let's do this. Take a duchy because I don't know why. And then, oh. Oh, he's gonna get Earth. Oh, he's gonna get Earth. Shoot. He has three pixies. He's gonna get Earth and then win. I can't do that. I can't actually do that. He's gonna get Earth. Can't take that many pixies. Too bad. So what? If he takes Earth, he takes two pixies, five pixies left. Well, maybe he can't even use them because he doesn't have the silvers. Province, duchy, pixie, race. 17. And then maybe just race. More races, maybe. Maybe just another duchy. I have no idea. No idea. Okay, so apparently just one pixie. I mean, one pixie is kind of what I wanted. Because now if he takes two, he still doesn't have the buys. Then I messed up the order. I messed up the order big time. I mean, nothing here then. Don't want to undo again. And also animal fairs. Maybe too risky. I don't know. Okay, this looks bad. Okay, probably can't use that. Oh. Kind of happy that he didn't get the field here. Field's gift would have been saving him. So field, earth, and the last one that I still don't know is left here, but now I have to hope to draw. Maybe I should have taken two provinces. No, I don't think so. I think one was fine. What should he do? Unclear, maybe province. Okay, that happened. So that happened. And all my animal fairs as well. Oh boy. He's gonna win now, right? Well, can he triple? He probably can triple now. I think I have to just score a bunch here. Province, state, animal fair is the most points I can get. Then he would have to score quite a bit, so I think I'll do that. I mean, he probably will be able to, but what can I do? I mean, could also take zero provinces. Is it more likely that he can triple or that he can like double plus something? He does have to pick these. I think I'm in trouble either way. Maybe I'm overestimating his deck. It could also be the case. He can score 8 points. I'm at 59. He would have to score 15. 16 rather. It's so easy. Is it? Is it easy? It's easy with the pixies and field and then animal fairs. He didn't play, he played one wayfarer. Okay, whatever. Okay, let's see. Yeah, he only has two wayfarers. I think I just overestimate his deck here. But I, in the meantime, well, yeah, he gets the field. I might just dud again. That would be so sad. Not even sure what I should pass here. Maybe the duchy. Does he still? Well, I keep on wondering what I should pass, and then he never played his mask, but now he's probably going to do so because. Oh man, passing the wayfarer is so bad. Everything is so bad. Because if I pass a rats, well, my turn is a dud for sure. He can pass a silver, right? That's funny. So is duchy really the correct pass? No. Yes. 6 points different. Double just wins then for him. I think I actually have to pass. I don't know. I have no idea. If I pass a rats, he can just trash it for more draw. Wayfarer, he can draw and win. He can win all the time. Doesn't really matter what I do. I think maybe passing duchy and hope he misses double is an idea. I mean, he has one wayfarer in there and he has seven covers, so everything is losing, unfortunately. Passing rats and hope misses double also doesn't help me because then I died and he has another turn. I think I have to pass duchy here. He passes a bazaar? Wow. That's some turn of events. Okay, he just has the double here in hand. Okay. Well, that was the 6 points difference, but he could have bought an estate. Okay. Yeah, that was a fun end game there. I was first player. Yeah, I don't know what I should pass there. I think passing duchy is fine, but he had it regardless, so. Oh, that looks kind of ugly with stone eight and cardinal and stuff. Well, cardinal, you're not gonna have a deck for a while, maybe. Between archive and things. What do? I can open. Could just open donate. Donate, pay off debt. Buy a cardinal. Buy a hideout. In that order. I could also do cavalry. Donate, but what does it do? Nothing. Horses don't really do that much. We got donate. Can also just play a you can toil. Can just play all the cardinals and always toil them. Yeah, we won't have a deck, but then we will start having one, and then cardinal is kind of annoying. The only real plus buy coming from nothing. I mean, there's storeroom, but So how bad is donate down to 4 coppers, pay off debt, buy a cardinal? I mean, horses, all right, maybe not that bad. With storeroom, you can make some use out of them. How would it look like? Cardinal, I mean, donate, keep 4 coppers, pay off debt, buy a cardinal, buy. Then I have six. Six. I think I kind of like that. I don't know. Oh, there's Necropolis. Do I care about Necropolis? I mean, Necropolis is, it's kind of like a hideout. I think I will actually keep it. I mean, I completely missed, of course, the thing being here, but oh, my cardinal might miss. Yeah, let's do it. Let's keep 4 coppers and a necropolis. Wait, what? That's like the reflex of trashing the necropolis, even though I said I don't want to do that. Okay, this time it worked. He's gonna donate. Oh, he buys a cardinal. For debt. The thing that can happen here is I buy cardinal and then he exiles it. Well, gonna get them back. Yeah, I think I buy a hideout, so maybe I should have trashed my necropolis. Please don't do it. Okay, nice. So here, I think I buy a hideout. I need to trash my coppers to not have a deck, basically. I mean, I could also buy a second cardinal. So now he donates. What does he have? He has two silvers and a cardinal. Yeah, so of course his deck is much better. I mean, he's first player. I think he donated a bit late for my taste. Why not donate turn two or something? I don't know. Well, he would trash to nothing now, obviously. Problem is, if I hideout, he's very likely to exile one of the two, and I don't really want to buy a second hideout. But having the four coppers is also problematic. By cavalry here, doesn't make much sense. Could also be lucky. Let's try to be lucky. Yeah, this is the worst outcome, I think. Yeah. Ah, no, probably exciting cardinal is worse. Okay, you can buy one more card here. What a weird board. Yeah, I don't know. Should I buy another hideout? Probably. Do I take one back just so it can get exiled? Maybe. Okay, I. It was nice. Yeah, but my deck is just so bad. Let's see how the Cardinal War goes. I might actually. Not sure what I should do. How many cards do I have in my deck? Three, four, five, six, seven, eight cards. So, should I trash the Necro? Probably. Buy another cardinal. I mean, it's kind of bad long term, but I can always toil. So he didn't trash it either, right? Yeah, I think I'm misplaying this, but exiles cardinal. So do I. Well, and now I won't be able to. Well, I will. I can just trash that hideout now. I can also trash a copper. Let's do that. Yeah, having cavalry is probably nice. You don't mind horses getting exiled, and you also don't really mind cavalry getting exiled. The style. Points toiling the cardinal. So I can buy a five here, which is probably going to be a cardinal. Buy an archive. Oops. Yeah, Cavalry, this was pretty good for him. Is it really just all about the Cardinals? I'm not even sure about that, but I don't see a better buy here. I'm not sure if I should discard. I mean, I could. I don't want to lose my hideout. I think I would keep that on the thing. So that I don't have a deck. Yeah, and this is the idea with the archive. You also won't have a deck, I guess, next turn. And he has the Necropolis, which is super nice. Because now my hideout is a bit troublesome. Yeah, I'm not sure. Maybe I should have not trashed the Necropolis. But then I would have only been able to. Maybe just buy a silver then instead of a cardinal, I think would have been fine. Yeah. Oh well. What do I do? I probably buy another cardinal here. Yeah, but here's the gold and the two silvers. And he won't have a deck next turn, so I'm not even sure that Cardinal does much. Maybe I should just buy a silver instead. If I buy a silver, at least I hit four. Yeah, maybe that's better. Caravan Guard, sort of interesting. It removes cards from your deck, basically, if you have a deck. So right now I have, in theory, four cardinals. Do I need to take the last one? Then I can't afford anything. Well, I can trash a cardinal then. I think I have to play this. And then buy a cardinal, don't discard it. He's probably gonna get the last one. Next turn I play hideout. Can he? No, I think I should just buy silver, right? He can't take two cardinals. So yeah. Yeah, silver, so I don't have to trash that cardinal. I could trash it. But no. Yeah, this spot is completely awful. But I think he's just pretty far ahead. But it's not easy to say what we should do next here. I mainly like his position because he has the Necropolis. I mean, gold and two silvers is also good for him and an archive. So he's everything. Yeah. And we're probably gonna split the cardinals, so I don't even have an advantage there. I mean, I can. It's just exiling the things. It is annoying, exiling golds and stuff, but it's not the end of the world. Yeah, I think trashing the necropolis was the biggest mistake. Just trash a copper there and buy a silver. The thing is, if I get to exile a cardinal from him, then I could potentially buy the last one if he buys one here. Oh, he has two silvers in exile. I kind of missed that. Oh, he can toil the cavalry. That's kind of nice. Yeah, that was nice. Selling horses is doesn't do anything. This, on the other hand, well, does something, but exiles a gold. Exiles a horse. And there's the thing now with the penultimate cardinal rule, right? Yeah, I think I buy silver here. Okay, this is gonna be cardinal gone for me. But I can buy an archive or a gold now, or the cardinal if he takes one. Oh, this is so stupid. Yeah, okay, it doesn't make much sense. I should just buy a gold. He can maybe just buy silver and then take his silvers back. Well, he can do a lot of things here, yeah, I suppose. Well, he doesn't have the money right now to do a lot of things, but. Yeah, this could take a while. So he does take one. Would be nice if I can exile a cardinal here. Oh, I actually do get to do that. Okay, let's buy them one. Well, I have to discard them now, right? he's probably not gonna have a deck this turn, right? He can just sit it out. I think I should should I exile a cardinal here? Maybe the first one also should have already been a. Yeah, I need that silver. Well, I can also play a hideout. Like this turn, I can do nothing. I mean, I can play the hideout and trash. Trash something, play two cardinals and buy, I mean, and then toil the rest and then buy like silver. He's not gonna have a deck. Well, maybe he will. I'm not sure here. Problem is at some wait. No. I didn't mean to click there. I just wanted to click somewhere else. Do I want to buy something? Yes, I want to buy something. Let's exile the cardinal, I guess.
Exile Silver. And play the Hideout and trash a Cardinal. Oh, he's gonna play more Cardinals. What am I thinking? So stupid. Okay, so what's the cardinal situation? I have four. And he has three. So I have four plus one. Oh, he also has four plus one. Right. So we both have four plus one. So do I trash a cardinal here to buy a silver? Looks like it. Do I take the silvers back? I'm not sure. Well, I probably don't. The next turn I can buy another silver. Okay, so I mean, the question is, do I take the silvers back now? Or should I not do that? I think I should. Yeah, I'm not so sure. Would be so cool if he exiled my hideout. Would it be so cool? I don't know. I could donate and trash it. So if I buy a silver here and don't discard from exile, he's probably gonna exile one cardinal. Unless I. Well, it's 50-50 then. If I take them back, maybe that's better. Maybe, he's gonna exile the silvers right away. Yeah. So what does Noble Brigand do? Nothing. I mean, I could take a Brigand if I like. Buys a gold and discards it, and then I play a cardinal, revealing silver and gold, and then he exiles the silver, and so I know gold is on top. And then the brigand strikes. But he's not gonna have a seven card deck, right? Well, maybe. By Stonehate, I'm interested to see what he's gonna trash. He just wants to save his cardinals. Trash a cardinal now and buy gold. Oh wait, this is the time where he's only gonna play one cardinal. Is that true? What's his deck now? What did he trash? Is four cardinals? Oh. Not a huge fan of that undo, honestly. But whatever. Yeah. Come on. I mean, I shouldn't care. It's doesn't matter for me. Maybe it matters for him as far as the standing goes. But yeah, I wouldn't ask for that, honestly. I've been already thinking about what I should do in my turn. I mean, I know it's no information and such, but yeah, so am I. But yeah, that's part of the thing. He's so far ahead, he shouldn't accept that, of course. I don't understand it, donate though, but yeah, also don't I have no idea what I should do. So I was mainly suggesting that as a joke, but I mean, if he says okay, then I'm up for it. Then we played like this 30-minute game for nothing, but I mean, you have the advantage, right? You have more cardinals, you have a gold in exile, but I think he thinks that that doesn't matter, and maybe he's right, maybe I'm just wrong. Maybe I should just do nothing. It's probably best, right? Just do nothing. What I can do, yeah, but then he can do the same, and then maybe it benefits him more than me, is buying caravan guards. Because they don't really increase your deck. I mean, they can be on top of your deck. Is the play order still set then? It is, right? Yeah, so the right idea was probably to do nothing, like don't blink. See what the other does. So this is probably not gonna end in a stalemate. Peasant with watch, rich war. Probably bridge. Silver, maybe silver. What does bridge do? I mean, bridge is basically a silver if you buy a 5 cost, but you could buy like Peasant Snowy Village, maybe. But of course, they can also collide. But hitting 5 is not a big deal. I think I'm gonna go with the bridge. And then a rather early Snowy Village, so having any terminals is not gonna be that big of an issue. You can take a second peasant. And then you have the soldier and stuff. So yeah, Snowy Village looks good. And then ultimately it's gonna be governess. So he does that as well. And then this happens. So here I'm probably taking the Snowy Village. See if he collided or bottom decked or whatever. Nope, none of the above. Here, I think I don't know what I should buy here. Have no idea. Yeah, I thought about the ward village. Didn't really do much though, but what else, right? Second peasant. Let's do this. Okay. That's an early procession. I don't know. Let's go with the second bridge. Okay, nice. Nothing missing so far. So pretty identical here, except he has. Well, he has a soldier missed. That's nice. Wait. When what happened there? Okay, he got it. I kind of missed him getting another peasant. Why can I not like draw a copper here? So here I think I take the procession. Can top deck that thing. Here I probably play the snowy first, in case I draw my procession. Looks like a better target on Walled Village. Okay. Okay, at least I didn't draw it dead, but I didn't hit five again. And I also can't top deck the Walled Village, so procession is gonna be sad next turn. Let's take a Walled Village. Oh, I have that bridge. I have that second bridge. That's pretty good. Can disciple that, procession that. Governor. Governor Snowy? Governor. Is it even Governor? I think it's Governor. So Governor Snowy or another peasant. Peasant probably too slow. Second Snowy also doesn't inspire me, but well, certainly Silver doesn't do that either. So it's, I think it's either Snowy, Peasant, or nothing. Another peasant might be fine. Try it. I have another buy even. Well, I guess we take second Snowy then. Though doesn't really do much. Well, no, I think I just take nothing here. Maybe that was wrong. Because procession and so on. You want to have targets. Yeah, I think I should have taken another Snowy there. So, what about the teacher thing here? Teacher looks good to me, sort of. There's no trashing, and you need some draw. He's buying lots of things, which I don't really like for me. Okay, let's draw. I have played the snow, so I can play exactly three actions here. Okay, I think I still draw again. So I will play the procession. Sure. Do I play it on bridge? Oh well, there's my disciple in there. I think I do this for sure. If it fails, unfortunately. But there is a. Is there a walled village down? No. Is there anything down there? I mean, other than disciple, obviously. Well, peasant. Oh no. Okay, what's the deal here? I feel like Walled Village procession looks good. Oh, there was another Walled Village. Never mind. Tracking like a god. And he's probably gonna draw me something anyway. Drawing the procession here would be kind of cool. So I can disciple it. Otherwise, I will just disciple the Walled Village. And then I will take a teacher, I think. Hey, look at that. But what to do now? Just don't take like all the governors. I guess he's gonna take all the governors. So maybe teacher doesn't look good. It's too slow. Too weak, too slow. Yeah, I mean, wow, what a turn he got there. Well, he should take three cover. He's also going to have his crypt. Okay, this game is over. What? I did that? Really? I mean, my deck does nothing. I think. Maybe it does something. Maybe he's afraid to empty governors, but I don't have anything going for me, do I? I only have one bridge. Anyway, how do we do this? Disciple is a 5 cost. So yeah, we just disciple the. I mean, the crypt was so nice for him. He's gonna win next turn. So much for the teacher. And he's gonna have two disciples. Wow, that escalated pretty quickly. Well, yeah, whatever. Let's disciple the proc. Sick festival. Can I somehow win? That seems like not really in the cards. Guess it would start with proccing a bridge. I gain a copy of it. I mean, what else should I do, right? So he's gonna win next turn, regardless. So draw with the governor. Or should I rather proc a governor? Let's draw. That failed. Province doesn't help me. So I need to hope that he can't win, which is super unlikely, but gotta try. I guess there was some out for me, but okay, take some cards here. I don't know. I think he could buy nothing here. I don't really want to lower like too much. I mean, he's not gonna. He can't really dart. He does have seven coppers stalled away. Maybe it should be just be proc and old village. It's impossible that he. I mean, whatever. It's just over. So exchange those. Maybe there was a small out if I draw like two my. Probably not though. Did I? Okay, now I even turned into a teacher. Oops. Well, that's not gonna matter, so who cares? Oops. I messed up the screen here. How to fix that? Can I do Control C? No. Oh no. Yeah, my OBS screen capture is off now. I just wanted to change the text. It's too O him now, right? Player order. Okay, let's try this. Okay. Not ideal, but I think it's better than before. All right. What's going on here? The tomb is back. So, Knights. Red catcher to trash. The only plus spy is the Sir Martin. I think I open red catcher and then something else. Silver experiment, something like that. Double red catcher is not crazy. I think I kind of like that. Not a big fan of Coven here, but maybe. No, probably not. Maybe. Kind of like the double red catcher here. It's not usually a thing. Is it a thing here? Or is it just a silver trying to hit five? Or. It's between silver and red catcher for me. I mean, experiments also something to consider, I guess. I think I'm going with double red catcher here. And now by like experiments or fishing village. Oh wow, look at that. Look at that. I'm gonna trash a copper and an estate and buy a fishing village maybe. Looks fine. He does hit the five, just like that. Okay, that knight is awful. Do I still want that? I mean, no, not now, but in general. So fishing village also looks a bit worse now if I don't even. Well, if I want Dame Molly. Just be a silver now. Can't let him have the only knight. The Molly's so bad though. That's awful. So Natalie is so good. Yeah, I guess because Natalie is so good, I should have opened silver. That was dumb. I didn't really look at that. Oh wow. Yeah, that was stupid. Should have seen how good Natalie is here. It's game losingly bad, sort of. Whatever. Let's play it. Let's play it. Let's play that. Now what? Dame Molly's so bad, but I can't let him have the knight, but maybe I just should. Desperation Coven? Not really. Yeah, I have no idea here. Chariot Race here. Maybe we trade knights now. Okay. Or another set of experiments. Let's go cherry trees. I Guess he trashes. I'm not even sure what he should trash here. Michael, also brutal. But I guess he can't afford it, so I will take it. He can afford it. Never mind. These in some random order by the margin. Kind of looks like we are gonna split the knights eventually. I will only play one of these. Knights, if any. Yeah, so let's keep this. Do we even call the rat catcher here? Looks like it's not responding. Am I connected? Oh. Apparently not. Okay, looks like I'm back. Trash. Continue. Okay, Michael is gone. Do I have enough money to buy things? Think I do. Not gonna call here, though. Hey, do I get a Snatterly? I think I will. He's considering trashing the silver. He does do that. Yeah, I could trash two coppers and buy like a silver, or I could trash two coppers and buy a fishing village, or I could trash nothing and buy a highway, or a hunting party, or a coven. Coven looks okay-ish just for the economy, but I think I prefer trashing. Mana is gone, so I think I have four coppers and a silver in my deck. Do I need to trash here? I shouldn't. So we both have. Wait, do I have? I have two knights to his one, right? No, okay, I miscounted. We both have two knights. Yeah, I kind of like the coven. Now, Okay. There goes the vendor. I will trash a copper here. Okay, that was lucky for him. So, hunting party here or second coven or highway. Highway looks kind of bad. I mean, yeah, highway looks bad. I think I actually go second coven here. Yeah, let's do it. Coven on top, which is probably gonna get trashed. That's a bit sad. No, I can trash the silver instead. That's nice. Okay, so I guess I should have mathed that out and not trash the copper, but at some point I have to, so who cares? What here? Cherry trees? Yeah, tomb is actually funny with knights. So, I should buy either highway or a coven here. He has 4 curses in exile already. I think a highway is fine now. Well, actually, highway can. Well, we're not gonna have the knights for that much longer, I don't think. Do you put the curses in the opponent's deck? Second coven is a bit late for him, I think. Do you play that rat catcher? I think I do. Okay, nice. Kind of have to put the curses into his deck. Take another highway because I don't see what else. Okay, my highway might get trashed here. I don't really care about gaining the curses. I think he cares a bit more. Maybe. Okay, so piles. Piles, piles, piles. Hello. Very low. What to do here? What can he do? He has 2 covens. And a silver. And lots of shared races. How does that work again? If your card costs more, you gain nothing, right? If I don't have a deck, well, but he can play the thing first. Oh, dang. Maybe I should wait with that, but then I can't buy anything. So, tricky. That's tricky. He can play a Coven and then he can play a Cherry Trace. How many Cherry Traces does he have? Three. So he plays a Coven and then he plays the Cherry Traces. I get to trash some curses next turn though. So let's just see what happens, I guess. By what? So, can I by any chance buy the Chariot Race? He's gonna play a Coven. And then he plays 6, 7, 3 Chariot Races. So he's still only at 14. But he will probably have enough to buy like a card. So, what do I buy here? Could be a duchy. Duchy looks bad. So, if I buy a coven, I still can't province next turn. He's only gonna gain the points for like one turn. Plays a Coven, then he plays Chariot Races, and then he buys like a duchy. But then I can buy a duchy. I could buy nothing here. So I have a higher chance of trashing more curses next turn. Sounds a bit far-fetched. And it was, I mean, the turn after my next one is what I. It's not really what I meant, but what I should have said. So he apparently doesn't have the Coven, or no, what's he doing? Does he not want to put the curses in my deck? I'm not sure. Could have scored 3 points there. Well, at least one. I don't know what. He has in hand. No, at least two, right? interesting. Maybe he didn't think of it. All right, I can see what he revealed. Okay, the last one was indeed a Coven, but. Things if they play highways, this knight can't trash his chariot races, which is a bit sad. Could trash a coven here. Buy another highway. That's dumb. Oh. What, you can province even? That's not fair. So, oh man, this is kind of funny. I'm first player. I'm the first player. And my top card is a curse. No. What was his play order there? I'm a bit confused. Okay, he played a Coven. Okay. And then he played Natalie. So, was that calculated? Maybe. Yeah, because my top card is a curse. I can't trash. can't trash three cards here and buy the chariot race. I mean, I can trash highway into covens and then I play the highway. And then I lose. So he's gonna win next turn if he sees the knight. Yeah, and if I trash Dame Josephine, then, well, I lose 2 points. It was probably pretty clever if it was calculated. I guess it was. I mean, he's pretty good. Oh, I only have 2 red catches on the mat. okay. Never mind. I thought I have 3 for some reason. So just lost, right? Well, he has some curses in his deck. Play those. I mean, I'm gonna dodge. Do I play that to top the curses? Guess I do. It's gonna be 2 curses. Yeah, I think that's worth it. Oh, it's gonna be 1. Never mind, I draw 1. Oh, I'm not sure I should have played that. But I did. Well, it's gonna be dodgy. Hope I don't top deck a curse, but I might. Oh, I guess you can just do that. Okay. Yeah, interesting. Another interesting game there. And I'm gonna lose all the games again. That's okay. I'm not sure what happened there. You got lots of chariot races. Maybe I should have dead sheet when I got the last, I mean my last highway. Maybe. Let's hope he also has four, three and open sacrifice so I can do the same. Otherwise, I'm not sure what I should do. Probably, I mean, double silver or sacrifice nothing. Double silver looks better, right? He does have the 4. Let's see if he goes sacrifice or double silver. Let's click on kingdom. So yeah, some stables, some spices mainly. Mastermind eventually. Does go for the silver. He's gonna have a dead if he goes double silver, but I think I have to follow. Can't really open sacrifice nothing. That's just too bad. I could do. No, I can't really do anything. So let's go silver. Is this a sack and then I'm missing 5 next turn? Is that really worth it? No, I think I just do silver here. Play like stable spices, money. Probably. Oh, and wait a second. No, never mind. I just miss 5 for no reason. So I guess I do take the sacrifice here then. I mean, it's pretty bad, but what can you do? Yeah. Yeah, not hitting 5 with double silver is not really good. I thought I'm gonna buy stables. What a fool. So, silver? Here, maybe a silver. I guess I should actually trash the copper and buy spices. And here, maybe another spices. Yeah, sacrifice was probably bad. It made me miss five once more. And now he has two more stables. I will buy stables eventually. But if I buy one now, I probably won't be able to do so next turn. Not sure if that's a valid argument, though. Does still go for sacrifice. I'm a bit surprised. Let's go spices. And here I buy spices. And here I will take my first stables, taking one debt. I could also like do stables animal fare. I think this is better. I wonder how many coffers I should spend. Like here, do you spend like four coffers? Or do you just buy a stables maybe? Not clear to me. Or spices. I think I actually spent the four coffers. Okay, this is bad. So here I might do advance plus stables. Is it better than just trashing a copper and buying stables? I think it is. Sort of. I mean, the game is not going to take that much longer. Or is it? Maybe it is. Can build with Mastermind and Fairgrounds eventually. Yeah, I think I do this. Stables. Yeah, and I also still have that one estate. I still have two estates. Wow. Okay. Yeah, but I'm quite a bit behind again here. Partially because I missed five, turn three and four, and then maybe also partially because I bought the sacrifice. Stable, stable spices, I think. Don't spend another five coffers. Oh no, you can't even do that. Money-wise. Maybe I should have traded that sack for an animal fare, I don't know. You don't even get the debt, right? If there's a debt token on Animal Fair. He goes for the Mastermind now, which I think is probably better than what I suggested. Don't know what to do. Let's also go Mastermind. We'll probably fail miserably, but maybe I should have done double Mastermind. And he, of course, has trashed all his estates already. Yeah, this is gone. He also has six stables. I think just. I'm not sure what he should get actually. If you
Because he doesn't want the mastermind to whiff. So do you take action cards here? I don't know which. I mean, you can buy like four heralds if you want to, but it seems a bit strange. Oh, you can do a herald top decking trick if you want to, but you're only top decking like a herald. Yeah, maybe province, double herald, top deck a herald, but I mean, herald is not really the best mastermind target ever. You could, no, there's no five, there's pillage. You could also top deck like procession and herald. Mastermind the procession. That doesn't do anything. You could, he doesn't have an action in hand though. Does he? Does he have the sacrifice? Where's the sacrifice? Huh, maybe he wants to top deck an animal fair. That's a lot of money and buys. So that's probably what I would do. Like buy animal fair. Okay, he would just. He could have top decked an animal fair. Kind of like that for him, I think. What can I do? Play my cards. Yeah, I'm not gonna trash an estate once again. Well, I could do it. I mean, it is some money. But who cares? He does have masterminds. I could also. I think I kind of like it, even though it doesn't really help me, but. Do I rebuy the sacrifice? Probably. I mean, the herald costs five. Then one dead. Oh, we only have two buys, so. Yeah, let's do it just for fun. One dead. Hey, look at that. Probably would have been better to mastermind. No, probably not. Probably not better to mastermind the stables. And also, I played all my stables, so. Right? I played four stables. No, I only played three, but he's gonna go off here with putting two masterminds in play and then winning next turn, something like that. I can double province, that's all I can do. And he can do the trick now. He can probably win next turn. Maybe I shouldn't have showed him, but I mean, he would have seen it himself. He's probably seeing even more than I do currently. Right, what happened? Nothing. Okay. Yeah, I'm not even sh yeah. Just buys a herald, okay. Just wants to top deck a herald. Yeah, his next turn is gonna be big. Four steps. I guess he wants to spend a coffers for double province. That's again a that's not a weird undo. Okay, never mind. Forget what I said. He just forgot about the debt on the province. He can he quad? Oh, did he set that up? No, right. He only top decked one card. Yeah, he only top decked one card. Can he quad here? don't think so. He didn't mastermind a one-off. He didn't mastermind a animal fair. Triple is good enough. Not even sure he should triple. I think he maybe should. But then he can't set anything up. So does he not want to play the mastermind, but rather trash it for an animal fair so he can guarantee the province next turn? Sounds like a decent plan. Man, these plays. Oh, he can just win. Okay, I guess that's also a good point. With the advance. All right. Win four. What's the record for fewest points in a season in A? I don't know. I went f no, he went first there. Not random. Oh wait, not ready. Spec chat. And liked card lists. So, what's happening here? Hmm. 3-6 is my opening split. Count looks. Looks okay to open with, I guess. You could also try to delay it and get some archives first and then trash bigger. It's probably too ambitious. There's no village and the only plus buy is tragic hero. I mean silver is probably the thing you click on here first. So let's think. Do I want the count? I probably want the count. So do I want a silver or a merchant? I guess I want a silver. So let's open silver count. That's a perfect draw, basically. Yeah, nice. And now I guess an archive. Livery also nice, but I want to be playing count a couple more times, and I think archive is fine here. I will take curses, I think. Or do I? Could also buy just a merchant here. Probably better. Okay, my top card is an archive. Do I want to trash or do I want to take another archive? I think I trash once more. It's not so clear, but let's do it. Yeah, it just takes some money and buy, like, what do I buy? Enclave doesn't look bad here, actually. Let's take a merchant. By what? Why did I take the merchant? Why did I not? Enclave here. No, whatever. Let's not ask for that. It's just. I mean, I could have enclaved here instead of buying a gold. Oh boy. I can livery and then enclave maybe. Am I already? Yeah, whatever. That was probably bad because I want to play. I want to play a tragic hero eventually, right? Maybe. I could also just start provincing after that enclave. Could trash like for the last time here. Or I could province. Let's do the thing that's probably a bit questionable. Especially with the horses coming in, I don't really need to trash like that hard. So, what here? I could play the cursed golden enclave. I could also just buy a gold. Buy a tragic hero now. Maybe let's do that. Play with three terminals with no village, why not? Sounds like a great plan. Here, probably another archive. No, probably not. Probably another enclave or something like that. He caught up when I did nothing in the meantime. So merchant is enough, right? What's down here? Tragic hero. Don't want to be popping that though. Tragic hero was probably not a good buy. Should have come a bit later. Let's take a horse. And well. Last card is the silver. That's bad. Okay. Yeah, Tragic Hero only gives a buy for a turn, so I have to decide when I want to use that, basically. I guess after we take some more golds in the second archive. So I can double province once, maybe. Maybe that's the plan. Okay, so my silver is down here, and the gold, right? Could take an archive now. Is that needed? Not really.
just do this and then I could province. Let's enclave those. I have three goals. Well, I could also try the tragic hero. Not to make it not pop. Sounds, I'm not sure how good that is. Yeah, here unfortunately it does pop. I could try that. Yeah, maybe don't take a second archive ever. And just try to play the hero every once in a while. I mean, I could also rebuy it. But then what's the point? You do get a gold. By the province. I think I just follow. With playing livery, let's keep the reserve hero. Like here, for example, if the merchant somehow draws the hero, I might just play it. Even though I might draw my archive dead and stuff, so maybe not a good idea. Does he gain a duchy now? I don't think so. He does. Takes the last two. Okay. Yeah, that's nice. Sort of. Sort of nice. Yeah, because now if he exchange provinces, he's just gonna win. But he might miss pretty easily, actually. Is easily true? I don't know. Yeah, there was again a pretty cool play, I have to say. Maybe I did I have the chance to do the same? My tragic hero is gonna be real tragic, I think. It's not gonna do anything ever. I mean, he does have a duchy in his deck now, but so what? Well, I guess that's the time for the thing. Didn't really do anything. Is venture better than gold? Kind of close. Gonna say yes. 12, huh? It's nothing. 12 does nothing. How many uniques do I have? Copper, silver, gold, duchy, province, venture, livery, count, archive, merchant. So 10. So I can do hero fairgrounds here, maybe, with playing the cursed gold. So again, if I play the cursed gold, maybe I'm not that far off 15 here. I have duchy province, copper, silver, gold, that's 5, duchy hero 6, venture 7, fairground would be 8, livery 9, count 10, archive 11, merchant 12, cursed gold 13, and I didn't count the curse yet, right? So that's gonna be 14. Did I count the tragic hero though? No. 3 for 5. I think I'm at 14 now. Let's play this by a fairgrounds and what? It's gonna be hard to get. I mean, the horse, I think, is my 14th card. It's a double fairgrounds. Probably right. Yeah. Yeah, the problem is gonna be the 15th. So again, I have Duchy Province, copper, silver, gold. That's four curse. I mean, that's five curse. That's six. And then I have the Venture 7, Fairgrounds 8, Livery 9, Count 10, Archive 11, Merchant 12. Curse 13. Ho no, I did count the curse. Counting is so hard. That's why I'm gonna be playing in B division next season. Counting there should be a lot easier. So I have six cards from the left-hand side, right? So that's six. Yeah, it's gonna be 14, right? Is it only 13? So what am I doing here even? Well, just playing province looks good, right? How do I do that? I guess I take the province in hand. And then play horse. Top deck a horse and take coins. I mean, I'm ahead here regardless. Yeah, I don't know what I'm doing. I'm a point ahead here. So he buys a fairgrounds. So we're gonna do that now, I guess, maybe for a while. Do I play the horse or do I take a curse? I guess I play the horse. Oh, wait a second. Oh, okay, I drew the silver, so this is fine. Oh, look at that hand. So now I buy what an estate, I guess. But then he's gonna province after he fairgrounds now. That's kind of sad. I mean, I could banquet for a tragic hero. That's not the best draw I ever saw, I have to say. Yeah, estate is only my 14th, so. And I do have a copper, so banquet doesn't help either. Maybe banquet for Tragic Hero is the right play. Kind of hard to believe. He's just gonna province. So let's say he provinces, and I buy estate. How many points is that? I have three fairgrounds, so it's six, 7 points. Doesn't really help if he can province again. Yeah, so there's that. Let's do it though. Mean, it doesn't really matter. It's by an estate. And somehow this was 15. So what is it? Is it seven? Seven from the left, and then I have a tragic hero. I guess I've, this time around forgot about the cursed gold. So now we can be certain it is 15. How many uniques does he have? I mean, I can't even count my own, so why should I bother trying to count his? Does he? Okay, he doesn't have an estate. Let's try. He has province, gold, silver and copper, and duchy and curse. That's six. Yeah, but then he only has fairground seven, livery eight, count nine, archive ten. And a horse, potentially. So he is missing my venture and my merchant. Sort of. So now I could province. Doesn't sound like a great idea, though. So I fairgrounds and he fairgrounds. And then I can buy a state. And he can buy. No, he can't really buy a unique, right? Because then a province, I mean, if I get there. Yeah, so fairgrounds. How do I best buy the fairgrounds here? I guess I take a province in hand. Yeah. So do I play that venture? No, I mean, I drew that crappy thing last time, so let's just buy a fairgrounds. Okay, so wait, what? Yeah, right. Okay, so I just have the province here. I mean, what am I thinking? Don't have to buy a state here. So how do I best do that? Could play the cursed gold. And next time take a horse, or I could take a horse now. Next time take the count, but I think it's better to take the count, top deck a merchant. What's my last card? I'm not gonna try to figure that out. Taking a curse is a bit annoying, I have to say. So maybe I take the horse, I don't know. It's a silver. So now I have seven. Do I trigger this? I shouldn't lose my last horse. I think I trigger it because I don't want to be gaining a curse into that shuffle. I mean, it's also gold. Whatever, let's play it. Oh no, that's too much money. Guess it doesn't really matter. Do I play the venture? I have like three golds. I think I'm gonna say no. Let's just buy this. okay, I mean, does he have the time? I think he should try to get up to 15. No, I think that's not correct to resign here. I mean, I don't think so. But hey, I take it. It's a win. Kind of forgot how that felt. All right, last one. Five, two. So recruiter nothing. Yeah, I guess I should have last turn taken the count, top deck the merchant and take the coins. Then I have merchant and silver on top. Which looks pretty good. Do I buy an estate? There's no reason not to, right? So it will get trashed before we green, so might as well take one more village out of it. So here I can trash something. I guess I trashed an overgrown estate. Oh, I can actually quest if I want that. Is that good? Maybe even. Sounds decent. What else? What's the game plan here? The gains. I mean, there's procession. I guess it's gonna be some crazy procession priest upgrade thing. But do I want a gold for that to just buy the things? That's the question. Probably not, right? Let's just take a priest here. Bandit is decent. Food. I mean, the goals for recruiter and priest. Takes it already. I guess I should just copy him. That's a good strategy, right? I mean, I want to play processions and stuff. For sure. Not sure I like the bandit. Could take a plaza here. Whatever, let's take a bandit. My recruiter misses. I guess I buy a sage then. I need a nomad camp. I would have bought a nomad camp had I hit four here. Oh, my recruiter got flipped. Yeah, that's a sad turn. Here, it's also a bit sad. Think I have to play recruiter first. Well, I could also play priest first, and then hope to draw an estate or a necropolis or the sage that I can trash to recruiter so I can play my bandit. Kind of always playing the priest, am I not? Yeah, I think so. Let's play priest first. At least I hit. But do I only just want the nomad camp now anyway? Whatever, I start with the priest. Okay, I trash the sage. And then could be procession now. With it's a bit early, but whatever. I'd like to. Oh, I just got rid of my sage, huh? I don't know what the procession does. Honestly, I need a nomad camp first. Probably gonna buy it this turn. And then I can procession it potentially. Play a priest, play a nomad camp. That's 2, 4, 6, 8. And then I can buy like nomad camp procession. I could also quest. Quest instead of playing the bandit is kind of funny. I mean, it does save me a villager, but it might also like not trash a gold, which I would have otherwise trashed. Okay, nice flip for me. I think I will just play Procession on Nomad Camp. I mean Priest first, and then Procession on Nomad Camp, play the Bandit, and it's 8 by like Nomad Camp and Plaza, something like that. Take another recruiter. What about an upgrade instead? Also not so bad. Take another recruiter though. Nomad camp and plaza. I mean, we don't have draw here really. So that's gonna be an issue with my plan. Another 8. Because you won't get the food to do cool stuff here and the draw with it. Let's go Plaza Priest. Well, I'd like to play a priest first, but on what? Maybe on the gold. It's so bad. I mean, the plan is not gonna work. Oh, here's a bureaucrat. Kind of missed that. Let's say I start by playing a priest and then play a recruiter. No. I think I just have to give up in green. Maybe buy a cash at some point. It's also 2 points. Second priest, I don't know what that does. It's not a priest mega turn here. Okay, so stretching the gold worth it. Probably not. I mean, it gives 4, now I have 7 instead. Maybe it's fine. Buy like 2 plazas, maybe. Plaza does nothing, though. Maybe it's better than a gold. Could buy a sage back just to have it. Whatever. Yeah, just province. Let's take a upgrade. I mean, I trash too many things here, but oh, he's at 30 points. Okay, so let's play a sage. Let's play a plaza. Let's play a priest. Let's play an upgrade. Trash ward. This is going nowhere, of course. Trisha Plaza into a cache. Play a Nomad Camp. Quests. Plus. Plus what? Gold? Possibly, maybe just the plaza. Let's go plaza. That's a lot of money. Let's proc. Maybe I should just procession the recruiter. I don't really know. Maybe I find my nomad camp here. Might be a duchy for him. Let's play the plaza. Let's treasure copper. Let's trash a priest. Let's play the upgrade. Treasure Plaza to a duchy. Play the camp. Do I play the bandit? Do I just quest it again? He played one gold last turn. Maybe I can snipe a gold. No. Okay, nice that I didn't have to top deck something here. Okay, it's still 8. So let's play a sage. Do I have more than one plaza? That's a tough question. Looks like it did, but not anymore. Let's upgrade. Well, whatever I trash here is gonna lose me points. Also, I should have probably done that differently. All I can do, no, I can't do that either. Okay, now procession at least is points. Oh, wait a second. I should actually treasure priest, right? I think. Should I buy a curse here? I mean, why not? He's got a province anyway, so it doesn't matter. All right. thanks for watching, everybody, and see you in the last one against Warfred on Sunday, I think. Yeah, bye-bye.